Hello my dear friends, I am Sasika Patel. Welcome you all in Deepam Gyan Kranti, the newly developed channel by Deepam English Institute. Friends, today we will discuss on the poem If You Call Me, that is written by Sarojini Naidu, and that is the part of FIBCOM VNSU syllabus. Friends, it's a very important poem, you can say. It's not only the part of the FIBCOM, especially in VNSU University, but in so many universities this poem is there. So it's very important. So before we start the summary of the poem, let us see about the poetress, means about Sarojini Naidu. So Sarojini Naidu was born on February 13, 1879. Okay, her father's name, that is Aghornath Chattopadhyay, and her mother's name was Sundari Devi. So you have to remember only the birth date, 13th February 1879. Now when she was only 16 years old, she went to England and studied in King's College at London at the age of 16. That you have to remember, means we can say she was very talented. And before her further studies, she went to England and studied in King's College, London. Now you know very well, if I'm talking about Sarojini Naidu, then one strike should be there in your mind. She is also known as the Nightingale of India. Friends, it's a very important thing. If you are writing any poetry of Sarojini Naidu, then don't forget to mention that she is the Nightingale of India. So it's a very important thing. Without this, please don't write your answer. Means it should be there in your answer, that she is also called as the Nightingale of India. Now if we are talking about the famous work or famous poetries of Sarojini Naidu, then some of the famous work are The Golden Threshold, that was published in 1905, then The Bird of Time, that was published in 1912, and The Broken Wing, that was published in 1912 again. Now she left this world on 2nd March 1949. So here you have to remember that birth and death, then famous work about hers, and then important thing, the tag or well known. So she is also known as the Nightingale of India. Now if you are talking about this poem, If You Call Me, that was a part that is taken from The Broken Wing. Okay, so you have to remember that thing, ki from where this poem is taken. So that is taken from the collection of the poem, and the collection of the poem, the name of that collection is The Broken Wing. So it's an important, you have to remember as far as this poetry is concerned, and you have to remember the Nightingale of India. Now as far as this poetry is concerned, If You Call Me, friends, you see the word if means condition. Okay, so if you call me, right now I'm not telling about that thing why the title is like that, if you call me, but later on we will discuss in this video only. So if you are talking about the type of poem, so it's a love poem. It's an also very important, because you are the students of literature, and when you are writing the answer, then first you have to mention about the fiction or poetry, whatever. So you have to remember type of poem is love poem. Then if you are talking about the poem If You Call Me, so the theme is love. You have to mention this thing also, that what is the basic theme on that the poem is written by Sarojini Naidu. So the theme is love. You have to remember that thing. Now which type of love? So it is typical Indian woman. Love of a typical Indian woman. Jo Indian woman hai, specially typical Indian woman, wo love kaisa hota hai? फॉर दैट बिलवेड, मतलब उसके लवर के लिए उसका लव कैसा होता है इंडियन लेडी का, दैट शोज इन दिस पोएम इफ यू कॉल मी. आई हैड ऑलरेडी रिटन फॉर यू द फीलिंग्स ऑफ द लवर्स, ओके, फॉर इंडियन वुमन. नाउ इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस पोएम, एज फार एज दिस पोएम If You Call Me is concerned, then we will come on a conclusion that love is the reason for existence. मतलब ये poem में कुछ ऐसा होता है कि you can come with the conclusion कि जो poetress है उसका जो मेन रीजन है वो कैसे जी सकती है. सो दैट इज एग्जिस्टेंस. एग्जिस्टेंस होना मतलब हयात होना. सो लव इज द रीजन. ओके एंड बिकॉज ऑफ हर लव फॉर हर बिलव्ड ही वॉन्ट्स टू सेक्रीफाइस हर लाइफ. नाउ लव इज द रीजन फॉर एग्जिस्टेंस एंड बीइंग कॉल्ड बाय हर लवर द वुमन विल रीच बाय हिज साइड विदाउट फेल. एंड इफ her lover call her to any of the help, then she is always ready to help him. So that is the main thing. Now one sentence is there, we can conclude into that poem, that is a mad call from a soul of her beloved will make her run and fly to him without caring any vestige hindrance. Matlab obstacle means if her lover call her by heart, okay, then without caring any obstacle, without thinking anything, any trouble, she is always there to help her lover. If you are talking about the symbolism of the poem, so you will get some symbols like mountain deer, dove, snake and charmer, all that thing. Means she compares her love and the helping position with certain kinds of symbols like mountain deer, dove, snake and charmer. If they are talking, when you see this word like dove, snake, charmer, mountain deer, so all these words with the help of this symbolism, she has expressed the feeling of sexuality between the lover. Okay, so let's see the poem. If you call me, I will come. Swifter, oh my love. Swifter matlab very fast. So she tell to her beloved, her boyfriend, her lover, that if you call me, condition is that if you call me, agar aap mujhe bulaoge, to I will come swifter, oh my love. Swifter matlab very fast. So very fast I will come to help you. Then a tramping forest deer or a planting dove, swifter than a snake that flies to the charmer's thrill. Now friends, see here, then a trembling forest deer. So certain words like forest deer and dove, they are used as metaphor. Okay, किसी की मतलब comparison करना. So he is saying कि the forest deer कितनी speed में run करता है, उतनी ही speed में. And panting dove मतलब dove flies very speedily for her lover. Means here he shows the sexuality between two characters, her lover and her. Then swifter than a snake that flies to the charmer's thrill. Now you know very well what is the relation between snake and charmer. Charmer matlab jadugar. To aapko pata hai ki when you go in circus or all that, to jo jadugar hota hai wo usko sound deta hai thrill se. Okay, thrill matlab captivity. To he makes certain sound. At that time you come to know ki jo snake hota hai, it comes very fast. मतलब as soon as उसको साउंड मिला तो डायरेक्टली वो स्नेक है, वो बाहर आ जाता है. आपने बहुत सारी मूवीज में भी देखा होगा, देखा है ना फ्रेंड्स. यस आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट ओनली. मतलब जब जादूगर है वो उसको बुलाता है स्नेक को, तो वो तुरंत ही आ जाता है. द सेम थिंग शी वॉन्ट्स टू टेल हियर कि इफ यू कॉल मी तो आई विल कम फास्ट, आई विल कम वेरी स्विफ्ट. If you call me, I will come swifter than desire. Desire मतलब wish. Now आपको पता है कि जो wish होती है, that is also very fast, you can say. तो what she said कि एकदम fast, desire से भी ज्यादा fast she will come. Swifter than the lightning speed. Now lightning speed मतलब fire जो होती है. Okay, it's compares here. Shod with the plumes of fire. Shod मतलब to wear, पहनना. जैसे फायर जो होती है एकदम स्पीड से स्प्रेड होती है, द सेम वे शी विल कम, बट द कंडीशन इज दैट इफ हर लवर कॉल हर. लाइफ्स डार्क टाइज माई रोल बिटवीन और डेट्स डीप क्रेमस डिवाइड. इफ यू कॉल मी आई विल कम फियरलेस बट वॉट बी टायर्ड. नाउ सी सेड कि आई एम नॉट वरीड अबाउट एनी डार्क टायर्ड्स ऑफ माई लाइफ. जितने भी प्रॉब्लम्स है आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व देम. आई एम नॉट लिसनिंग टू एनी वन. उसको कोई परवाह नहीं है सोसाइटी की. नॉट फॉर प्रॉब्लम्स, नथिंग. द कंडीशन इज दैट कि इफ हर लवर कॉल तो कोई भी सिचुएशन में इन एनी पोजिशन एनी सिचुएशन इज ऑलवेज रेडी टू हेल्प हिम बट द कंडीशन कि इफ यू कॉल मी. ओके नाउ फियरलेस वॉट बीटाइड. बीटाइड मतलब समथिंग दैट मे हैपन. शी हैज नॉट वरीड अबाउट एनी थिंग वॉट विल हैपन आफ्टरवर्ड्स. मीन्स यू कैन से the poetess Sarojini Naidu has nicely described the love of a typical Indian woman. Now आपको पता है जो Indian woman होती है she loves her husband very much and her husband is everything for her. The same thing is written by her here. Now if you observe this poem तो certain rhyming words are there. Like see love dove. तो यहाँ पे व साउंड इज कॉमन. यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर फ्रेंड्स इफ द साउंड्स आर सेम द साउंड्स आर अलाइक मींस इट इज नोन एज राइमिंग वर्ड्स. सो लव एंड डव बोथ आर द राइमिंग वर्ड्स. देन यू फाइंड डिजायर एंड फायर. सो र साउंड इज अगेन कॉमन सो इट्स अ राइमिंग वर्ड. देन डिवाइड एंड बीटाइड तो ड साउंड इज देयर सो अगेन इट्स अ राइमिंग वर्ड. Now she has used certain words like desire, lightning, life's dark tiredness, death's deep. All that word shows the eagerness to meet her lover. Which words that I marked with the red pen? ये जो words है with the help of that words, she wants to show the eagerness to meet her. Lover, her boyfriend, or we can take as a if we are talking about the bride way, if we are talking about the white sins, then you can come to know ki if Indian woman is there, so definitely she is ready to do anything for her husband. So we can take another way also ki that one wife is telling to her husband, she is always ready to help. Okay, but we have to take in a sense of a lovers. Okay, means Sarojini Naidu. जो है उसने बहुत अच्छे से डिस्क्राइब किया है कि इफ द गर्ल इज रेडी टू हेल्प हर लवर बट द कंडीशन इज देयर कि इफ यू कॉल मी. ओके सो सर्टेन वर्ड्स यू कैन फाइंड डिजायर लाइटनिंग लाइफ डार्क टाइड्स एंड ऑल दैट थिंग दैट शोज द ईगरनेस ऑफ द लवर टू मीट हिम. देन ही सेड कि नॉट इन सिंगल इश्यूज और नॉट इन सिंगल कंडीशन और बीटाइड कैन स्टॉप हर. ओके वो कोई भी ऐसी सिचुएशन नहीं है जो उसको स्टॉप कर सकती है उसको नहीं मिले पर. मीन्स ही इज ऑलवेज रेडी. मीन्स वी कैन कम विद द कंक्लूजन कि इट्स अ टिपिकल इंडियन वुमन एंड शी इज ऑलवेज रेडी टू हेल्प. बट अगेन देर इज अ क्वेश्चन इफ यू कॉल मी इफ कंडीशन इज देर. बिकॉज आपको पता है कि हम किसी को नहीं बोलेंगे तो सामने वाला पर्सन गॉड तो है नहीं कि उसको सब समझ में आ जाएगा. मीन्स जब उसको जरूरत है एंड इफ ही कॉल टू हर देन डेफिनेटली शी विल कम देयर टू हेल्प हर. मीन्स ही इज रेडी टू एक्सेप्ट एवरी थिंग. ओके नाउ आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज इट्स अ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर पोएट्री ऑफ सरोजिनी नायडू. तो आई ट्राई माई बेस्ट टू कन्विंस द मैसेज. स्टिल इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट देन यू कैन राइट इन कमेंट बॉक्स. आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व योर क्वेरीज. एंड इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो देन प्लीज लाइक इट, शेयर इट विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल. टिल देन गुड बाय, हैव अ नाइस डे एंड टेक केयर.